What's going on? Welcome back to my channel, Carnivorous Beast. So this week I wanted to talk about one of the most common excuses I hear for not living a healthier lifestyle and not wanting to improve health and well-being, and that is I can't be bothered. Now, if you haven't already done so, please hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to like and share this video. And also, I'd like to know what you think about this video. What your answer is to this excuse as well. I'd love to hear that, so put that down in the comments down below. Now, without further ado, let's get to the meat of the video. Now, this is the excuse that gets to me the most. I mean, you can't be bothered. So you can't be bothered to be healthy and be the best version of you. Of course you're not, because it's the same people who are the first to complain about any ailments they have. That's when it bothers them, when they have these complaints and ailments. Then, well, I'm sorry, but if you can't be bothered, then that is just not good enough. If you can't be bothered to cook, you are ignoring the most important elements of life, or one of the most important elements of life. If you'd rather replace real food with convenient and processed foods, such as cereals, for example, then expect to live an unhealthy lifestyle. If you can't be bothered to exercise, then you have made the decision not to honor your body. Your body is one of the greatest instruments that you will ever own. Look after it, work for it, feel, you know, good in your body. Nourish it with real food and just stop poisoning it with these processed and fake foods as well. So, to quote a great philosopher of our times, Master Yoda, do or do not, there is no try. There are people who claim to have tried to improve themselves. Well, you haven't tried. You failed, and you've let that failure get to you. So you either do it or you don't. You make that decision. Alongside this is that age-old excuse of I haven't got enough time. Now I say, really? The average person spends about 2.5 hours a day on social media. They also spend about 3 hours a day watching TV. Now, taking into account work and sleep as well, that totals at around 16 hours a day. That leaves you with 8 hours just for you. And even if you added in the 5.5 hours of social media and TV, if that's really what you wanted to do, if that's what you think is good for you, that still leaves you with 2.5 hours of a day to prepare real food, to do a workout, whether that be in a gym or at home or outside for a run, you know, going out for a walk as well. It doesn't have to be, you know, extremely strenuous. Even reading a book, there really is no excuse. Everybody has the same amount of time and everybody can manage it. And even if you still do not feel like that you have enough time, do what I do sometimes. If I'm preparing food, I may watch something at the same time on my laptop or on my phone. I may listen to something as well, you know, podcasts or anything on YouTube possibly. You know, you can do two things at once. Why not do that? You know, why sit in front of the TV watching something that's not going to benefit you? Whereas you could watch the same thing, but prepare yourself real food and make yourself a healthier person who wouldn't have so many ailments in the future, who wouldn't suffer from illnesses, who may start to feel a lot better within themselves, may feel a lot more energized to do more things by feeding yourself real food. Now, I know I may have gone on a bit of a rant there and you may be thinking, well, what's this got to do with the carnivore diet? So, what I can tell you is, since eating in a carnivore way, I have become far much more productive. I have read 15 books so far this year. Now, previous to that, I hadn't even probably read a book a year. I struggled to concentrate, I struggled to focus on that. And by being able to, by eating a carnivore diet, I have become much more focused on things. I can put my attention so much easier towards things that I want to do for myself. I feel a lot more aware of my surroundings. I previously talked about my mental health issues where, you know, again, I'm not going to say that they've completely gone away. I do still have my bad days, but most of overall, I can cope with things now. I have the mental and the physical sort of capacity to deal with these things. So this isn't just me having a go and having a rant at you guys. It's me telling you guys that there is a better way of doing things. Stop giving in to eating these processed foods and stop settling for convenience, because it isn't doing you any good. It's not doing you any good up here or on your body. So please, if you take anything away from this today, just stop eating fake food and start eating real food and looking after your body. So that is it from me today, guys. I would love to know what you guys think about what I've said today. Please throw that in the comments down below. And again, if you haven't already done so, please subscribe, hit that like button, and share with anyone who you think may need this little kick and this little nudge just to get them going. Hopefully I can have helped them. Thank you very much for joining me once again today, guys. And I can't wait to see you again soon. Take care.